Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 12, percentage. Now, there are some points which you have to remember. Now, what is percentage? Now, here the word cent means 100. Now, percentage, the word cent, it is the meaning of 100. Percent means per 100. Percent means what? Percent means per 100. And the symbol for percentage is, now this is the symbol of percentage. A percentage is a comparison made with a total which is taken to be 100 parts. Now, what is percentage? Now, percentage is a comparison between the total which has been taken from the 100 parts. Now, equivalent fraction can be used to make the denominator 100. There are equivalent fraction. Equivalent fraction means the fraction which having equal values, that is called as equivalent fraction. Now, equivalent fraction also can be used to make the denominator 100. So, here percentage means it is coming out of 100. Now, the symbol for percentage is, this one is the symbol of percentage. It will be taken from 100. Now, let's see some example. Okay. Now, see the first example there. Now, it is given 25% of 100. 25% of 100. So, what you will write? 25 you will write. Percent means it is 100, so it should be upon 100 into, of means into, then 120. Now here 25% of 120, 25% of 120 means what you have to do? You have to write 25% means it is 100, so it should be divided by 100 and multiply by 120, because they are asking of 25% of 120. 120 ka 25% kitna hai? So, see, 25 and 100. Now 25 and 100 is going in the table of 25 only. So here 25 ones are 25 and 25 fours are is 100. So that only written 1 upon 4 into 120. Now if we multiply 1 into 120, it become 120, and 4 as it is we will write. Now this we have to see which this number is going in which table. Now 120 and 4, that means 4 is going in 4 table. 12 is also coming and 4 is also coming. So 4 ones are 4 and 4 threes are 12. 1 0 you will take over here only. So it is how much percent? 30%. Now they are asking about 25% of 120. So 120 ka 25% is how much? It is 30. It is how much? It is 30. So this way you have to solve the percentage sum. Now we will see next another example over here. It is given 40 upon 100. 40 upon 100 means how much percentage? It is 40%. Now 100 means 100 में से इसको कितना मिला है? 40. That means it is how much percentage? It is 40%. Now next it is given 3 upon 100. Now 3 upon 100 means 100 में से 3 मिला है. That means how much percentage? It is 3%. 11 upon 100. 11 upon 100 means also 11%. Same way 25 upon 100. That means how much percent? 25%. Now percent is always calculated on 100 only. So here next is 43 upon 100 means how much percentage? 43%. And the last one is 100 out of 100. 100 out of 100 means how much percent he will get? He will get 100% only. See, percent we are using in our exam. Now your mother and your father is asking how much percent my child scored. So in this way you can calculate your own percent, how much you are getting in the exams. So this is the way you are going to calculate percentage. Now we will start with our practice set 30. Now you can see the first question there. Shabana scored 736 marks out of 800 in her exam. Now Shabana exam was there, out of 800 she scored 736 marks. Now what percentage of the marks did she score? Now how much percentage of the marks did she score, that we have to find out. Now in solution we have to assume that the Shabana score will be x percent of the marks. So first statement you have to write suppose, that means assume. Suppose Shabana score x percent of the marks. Now x percent means what you have to write? X upon 100 equal to 736 upon 800. Now 736 marks she got out of 800. So your statement must be x upon 100, because we have assumed that Shabana she's score has been x percent. So x upon 100 equal to 736 upon 800. Now here x upon 100, that means it is division. So we have to do multiplication both the side by 100. So here x upon 100 should be multiplied by 100 equal to 736 upon 800 multiplied by 100. Now this 100 and this 100 will cut it down. Now we will do cutting over here, 0, 0. Then this 0 will cut and this 0 also will cut. Now here 8 ones are 8. See here. Wait, I will show over here. 736 upon 800 multiplied by 100. Now here 20 will cut, here 20 will cut. Now you have to divide 736 by 8. Now it is coming in 8 table. 8 ones are 8. 8 nines are is 72. 1 we will carry over, it becomes 16. Now 8 twos are 16. That means how much percentage she score? She score 92%. So the final answer, the statement sum is there. So you have to write a statement. The statement is Shabana score 92% marks in her exam. Okay, so the next question is, there are 500 students in the school in Dahihanda village. See, there are 500 students in the school Dahihanda village. If 350 of them can swim, from 500, 350 students are swimming, what percent of them can swim and what percent cannot? Now what they are asking you, they told us there are 500 students in a village. From that 500, 350 students are swimmer. They can swim. But what you have to find out? You have to find out the percentage of swimming student as well as the student who are not swimming. So both the thing you have to find out. Swim kitne kar rahe or swim kitne nahi kar rahe. So your first statement is what? Total number of students in the school. Now first total number of students in the school, there are 500 students. Now number of students who can swim, jo swim kar rahe, that are 350. 50. Now we have to find out who are not swimming. So here first we will write down, suppose x percent of the student can swim. हम लोगों को क्या पहला हम what we have to find first? First we will find the percent of the swim student and then we will find out the percentage of the not swim student. So we have to write, suppose x percent of the student can swim. So that will be x upon 100 equal to 350 upon 500. See, 350 why I have written? Because 350 students are swimming. Out of how many students? Out of 500 students. So we have to find out first the percentage of the swim student. So here x upon 100 is equal to 350 upon 500. Now same way, x upon 100 multiply by 100 equal to 350 upon 100 multiply by 100. Now what? This 100 and this 100 will cut it down. Now I will show you the cuttings. 350 upon 500 multiply by 100. Now see here, 10 here, 10 here, cut it down. 10 here, 10 here, cut it down. Now what is remaining? 350 should be divided by 5. Now 5 ones are 5. Now 5 ke table mein 7 ja 5 7 ja is 35, and 0 we will take up as it is. So how many percent of the students are swimming? That are 70%. So I have written 70% of the student can swim, but they have asked you about the not swim student also. So here the percentage is calculated on how much? It is calculated on 100. So 100 में से minus करना है 70, because 70% students swim कर रहे हैं. So 100 minus 70 is how much? It is 30. So 30% of the students, they are not swimming. Here how many percent of students are swimming? 70. How many percent of students are not swimming? That is 30. How you are going to calculate? You are going to subtract 100 minus 70, because percentage is always calculated on 100. So 100% minus 70% is equal to 30%. So there are 30% of the students, they can't swim, and 70% of the students can swim. Okay, now we are moving to our next sum, that is question number third. Now question number third is, if Prakash saw Jawar on 75% of the 19,500 square meter of his land, how many square meter did he actually plant Jawar? Now here Prakash, he saw Jawar on 75%. 75% of the 19,500 square meter of his land. We have to find out how many square meter did he actually plant Jawar. Usne Jawar kitna square meter mein lagaya tha. That we have to find out. Now here, what we have to assume? We have to assume that Prakash sowed Jawar on X square meter of his land. Now X square meter, see here, percentage is already given. Now be concentrated over this sum. 75%, that is already given. In our previous two sums, we have find out X percent. Now in this sum, they are asking about the square meter. So we have to find out, we have to write, suppose Prakash sowed Jawar on X square meter of his land. Now here X square meter means X should be divided by, now how many square meter is given? 19,500 is given. So here X upon 19,500 equal to How much percentage? 75 percentage. That means 75 upon 100. Now, don't get confused regarding this type of sum. See, 75% is already given. You have to find out the actual square meter. How much square meter he has planted jawar. So, here the first will be x upon 19,500 equal to 75 upon 100. Now, x upon 95,000 should be multiplied by 100 equal to 75 upon 100 should be multiplied by 100. Here is some mistakes over here. See, here you have to multiply x upon 19,500 should be multiplied by 19,500. And here 75 upon 100 is also multiplied by 19,500. So here this 19,500 will be cutted and this 19,500 will be also cutted down. Now look here. Now next is what? 75. See, I will write here 75 upon 100 multiply by 19,500. Now here 10 10 here 10 10. What is remaining? Only one is remaining. So what you have to do? You have to multiply 75 by 195. 195 should be multiplied by 75. Now start multiplying in your notebook and tell me the answers. Is this answer and your answer is matching? That means if we multiply 195 by 75, we are getting answer as 14,625. So our last statement should be Prakash planted jawar in 14,625 square meter of his land. How much land? How much square meter he require? He require 14,625 square meter. I hope you people have understood this sum. Okay. Now, next question is question number 6. That is, in the election, 1,080 of the 1,200 women in Jambulgao cast their vote. Now, here in Jambulgao, there are 1,200 women. From that 1,200 women, 1,080 women, they have voted. Now, next, while 1,360 of the 1,700 in Wadgaon cast their. Now here in Wadgaon there are 1,700 women. In that 1,700 women, 1,316 women they have voted. You have to find out in which village did a greater proportion of women cast their votes? In which village? You have to find in which village the voting are higher. That means in Jambulgao or in Wadgaon. In both the section, in both the village, which village are giving highest votes? So first statement will be total number of women in Jambulgao. Now first we will take which gao? Jambulgao. Their total number of women are 1,200. And Number of women in Jambulgaon who cast their vote. Now, how many women they have casted vote? That is 1,080. Now, here the next gaon is which one? Total number of women in Wadgaon. In Wadgaon, the total number of women was 1,700. And from there, how many women they have voted? They have voted 1,360. See, the first statement we have to write total number of women in Jambulgaon and how many women they have voted. Same, we have to write total number of women in Wadgaon and how many women they have voted. This would be our first four steps. Then afterward, we have to write, we will assume Jambulgaon as X. See, we will assume Jambulgaon as X and Wadgaon as Y. Now we will assume Jambulgaon as X and Wadgaon as Y. So first we will solve the problem of Jambulgaon. Now here in, let X percent of the women from Jambulgaon village cast their votes. Now X percent means X upon 100 is equal to 1,080 upon 1,200, because total was 1,200. From that 1,080 women have voted. So X upon 100 equal to 1,080 upon 1,200. Now here we can see the calculation. X upon 100 multiply by 100 equal to 1,080 upon 1,200 multiply by 100. The same process which we have done in the previous sums also. So here 100 and 100 will be cut down. So here 1,080 should be divided by 1,200 multiply by 100. Now what you will write over here? See, this zero and this zero will cut. This zero and this zero also will going to cut. Now we will see this 12. 1,080 should be divided by 12. Now in 12 table, 108 is coming. So 12 ones are 12 and 12 nines are is 108. Now that zero we will carry over. So how many percent of the women voted in Jambulgaon? That was 90%. Now as we got the number of women voted, that was 90% in Jambulgaon, the same way we have to find for the Wadgaon. Okay. Now you can see over here, we have assumed X percent for Jambulgaon. Now I told we have to assume Y percent for Wadgaon. So here we will assume Y percent of the women from Wadgaon village cast their vote. So Y upon 100 equal to how much was there? There was 1,700 women. From that 1,360 women they have voted. So your X upon 100 equal to 1,360 upon 1,700. Now we will do the same multiplication, that is X upon 100 multiply by 100 equal to 1,360 upon 1,700 multiply by 100. Now this 100 and this 100 will cut it down. Here we will do a calculation. 1,360 upon 1,700 multiply by 100. Now 1010. Here also 0 cut. Here also 0 will cut. Now in 17 table we have to divide 17 by 1,360. So here 17 vanza is 17 and 17 eightsa is 136. This zero we will carry over up. So it will become 80%. Now 80% is of Wadgaon and 90% is of Jambulgaon. They ask which village they have voted more. Now by getting the answer 90% and 80%, we got that 90% is which village? That is Jambulgaon. So Jambulgaon women, they have voted more. So here the statement must be 90% of women cast their vote in Jambulgaon and 80% of the women cast their vote in Wadegaon. So here the greater proportion of women was cast their vote is in Jambulgaon. So Jambulgaon women, they have voted more, that is 90%. So their proportion is greater. So the last statement will be a greater proportion of the women cast their vote is in Jambulgaon. I hope you people have understood. So here we have completed our chapter number 12, that is percentage.